Hi everyone, I just wanted to introduce you to my new kitten. So sitting at home doing some writing one day when I heard this cat in distress, little kitten calls of sort of meow, meow, meow. So I went outside and the road opposite my house is tiny, tiny little ball of fur. My neighbour was there shaking out her sheets and sort of looking at it, not knowing what to do. So, you know, I asked, can I take it? And she was very, very glad for me to do that. So I picked up the little ball of fur and I brought it home. Now, I already have three other rescue cats that I picked up 5 years ago. I was in a Rwanda lesson and the lady who ran the cafe where we were having the lesson, she came in and she'd found a bag of kittens outside and she asked if anybody would take them. And everybody else very sensibly looked at the floor and stayed quiet, and I might have raised my hand. So I ended up with four kittens, three of whom survived, and named them after Ghibli characters. So I've got Howl, Sophie and Sen. And this little mite has been with me since the 22nd of March. He was probably about 6 or 7 weeks old when I found him. He was in pretty good condition, but he was a little bit stinky and hadn't been cleaned for a while. So I washed him up. And as young kittens often do, he had a tiny bit of conjunctivitis. So I just gave his eye a saline bathe and that was okay again. And from the very, very first moment that we met, he was incredibly affectionate. And he's growing up to just be the happiest little kitten in the world. He still doesn't have a name yet because I've had a couple of very sad incidents with kittens in the past where they haven't made it. And so I just wanted to make sure that he was going to make it to adulthood before I gave him a name. But he went to the vets on Monday and he was neutered. And at that point, I tend to feel that you've become a member of the family. So he's incredibly healthy. He's been neutered because, as everybody knows, cats multiply on a massive scale. And that's how we end up with abandoned kittens in the first place. And, you know, cats don't have a good life here in Rwanda if they don't have somebody to take care of them. Cats and dogs are not often welcomed. So it's not like India where people would just go up and feed stray animals. Here, animals who are stray on the street tend to have very short lives and not very happy ones. So obviously, I don't want to contribute to an animal being in distress in the future. So all of my strays are spayed and neutered and vaccinated. So, you know, he's healthy, he's vaccinated, he's neutered, he's a full member of the family. And so now is probably time he had a name. So I generally name all of my cats after Ghibli characters, like I said, Sophie, Hal, Sen. And I was trying to run through Ghibli names, but I couldn't find a really good one that I liked. There was Markle, but I thought people might wonder why I called him Markle, especially as because in the book of Howl's Moving Castle, he's actually called, I think, Michael Fisher, not Markle. So Markle was a Ghibli invention. So I don't know about that. And I'm leaning more towards maybe calling him Alucard from Castlevania because his eyes are golden. All of my other cats have green eyes, but his eyes literally look like a picture of Alucard. So, you know, he's kind of crazy destructive. He flies through the air. He pounces on everything. So, you know, I was kind of thinking that he's an Alucard maybe. But, you know, I don't know. It hasn't quite settled yet. So I'm open to suggestions below. So, yep, he's definitely living with me now and he is a member of the family. So welcome, little kitten with no name.
Cat bum. Right there. Yep. You've definitely got a cat bum. Stinky creature. Stinky creature. Here you are. Stinky yet wholesomely beautiful. Little ball of mayhem. Little ball of mayhem, yeah. Yes, you are.